It's 4:30, and on WKYT this morning, an overnight armed robbery triggers a campus-wide alert at UK. A full report on that situation coming up.
Winter weather may have passed, but the aftermath still being affecting parts of the state. We'll have the details coming out.
And we're still looking for a few flurries, a few flakes flying around. It's nothing that's going to be significant, but it's still there. When can we get a break from this winter weather? I'll go over your latest forecasts coming up.
Tracking, alerting, protecting. This is WKYT This Morning.
Good morning to you. It is Monday. Hope you had a good weekend, able to warm up a little bit, but here comes more cold weather. I'm Bill Bryant.
And I'm Rebecca Smith. For the first track on the weather, let's turn to meteorologist Micah Harris.
Can't get a break. I mean, that's really what it boils down to, is we're looking outside. A couple of flurries, a couple of flakes. It's nothing big, nothing significant, but man, it would just be nice to say, hey, we have no snow chance for today. First Alert Defender live radar. There's your look. We have a boundary to the north and one down to the south. Both of those throwing out a few flakes here and there. Current temperatures 15 in Covington, but look across the region. We're there in the 20s and even a couple of 30s down in the southern zones due to that cloud cover. It's not really allowing us to fall that much. So right now across the region, it is pretty cold and it'll stay that way. Actually, we get colder as the day moves along, 18 degrees, a small chance as we look toward the morning hours. Now, heading in throughout the rest of the week, it goes up and down, and I'll explain that forecast coming up.
Okay, we'll see you in just a bit, and we thank you very much, and let's get to the news. New this morning, UK police have issued a campus-wide alert after a robbery near the university overnight.
Police were called out to a Speedway gas station on South Limestone Street just after 2 o'clock this morning. That's where officers say two men, one of them armed, walked into the store and demanded cash. Investigators say the suspects were two men, one wearing a gray hoodie and sweatpants, the other a black hoodie and khakis. Lexington police are investigating. No injuries were reported. A man is in jail this morning after Lexington police arrested him in connection with a weekend shooting. Officers say 59-year-old Raydell Freeman shot at a man at a home on Bright Avenue Sunday. We're told the victim suffered a gunshot graze to the head. Crews took him to UK hospital with non-life-threatening injuries. Police say the victim told them Freeman shot him. Well, many folks in southern and eastern Kentucky are without water this morning after a drop in temperatures over the weekend caused some pipes to break.
A lot of melting going on. And in Knox County, volunteers with the Red Cross spent the weekend handing out bottled water to families in need. WKYT's Jordan Valiens spoke to some people who are trying to get by without water.
DeWitt isn't only one of the largest communities here in Knox County. It's also one of the communities most affected by this weekend's flooding as last week's snow now begins to turn to slush.
The melted snow and slush resulted in this.
Side road here's flooded out for probably the first mile of it.
Widespread flooding across the county.
I mean, the bottom of our parking lot this morning was filled full of water.
Even flooding out roads that were passable by car just yesterday.
It's dangerous. Yeah. It is dangerous. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we've had people get drowned, fall on the side of these roads and drowned in here.
But Dallas Brown faced the flooded roadways.
It's put us in bad shape.
In hopes of bringing back bottled water.
Can't even cook. We run a restaurant up in.
His house and his business.
It did. It affected us bad.
Currently, yeah. Both without water.
Bathrooms won't work.
He's one of the hundreds who went without running water Sunday due to pipe problems in the county. And while running water is scarce.
We've got water here, but might not have water this tonight or tomorrow.
The water line from creeks and dams only continues to creep further into the backyards of many.
Neighbors, you know, community members, yeah, it affects them greatly because, I mean, their houses, a lot of these trailers, you know, within 30 feet of the water.
And with temperatures expected to drop again on Monday, that of course means that this slush could freeze over, so city officials are urging all drivers to be safe. In Knox County, Jordan Valiens, WKYT.
And other communities in southern and eastern Kentucky have been dealing with a shortage of water as well. Pike County leaders expect about 75% of homes to be without water by this morning. Crews say all of this week, ice and debris have piled into the rivers and also blocked pumps. It's making it very difficult to access drinking water there. Crews are asking everyone to use water in their homes sparingly.
So what you'll see is very low water pressure people coming in. Into your line, into the home. So what we're asking is, again, since the pressure is limited and since the source of the resource is limited, it'll take us about 2 weeks to get our full reserves built back up.
Several fire stations in the Pike County area are offering water to those who are without.
A fire in one central Kentucky town could not have come at a worse time this weekend. The fire in Lawrenceburg Sunday morning destroyed the city's snow removal equipment shed. Lawrenceburg's mayor tells us he spent the day talking with other city leaders, trying to figure out what to do now about snow removal over the next few weeks. Investigators still looking to figure out what caused all this. In addition to losing all their snow equipment, the city says they lost a backhoe and some sewer trucks. A mess. Well, a Woodford County family says they have their pet to thank for saving their lives. Firefighters tell us that smoke detectors in a home on Delaney Ferry Road were not working Sunday morning when the fire started. So one of the men living there says his daughter's dog, Axel, started barking and woke everyone up. Firefighters say the home does have some serious damage.
All right. Good deed there by Axel. Firefighters in Lexington are warning residents to watch out for icicles this week. On Sunday morning, an 11-year-old girl was walking near the Garden Brooks Apartments when an icicle from the gutter fell and nearly hit her. Firefighters believe the increase in temperatures may be causing the ice to fall. They say it is important to be mindful of walking under roof overhangs. Road crews in Lexington didn't take a break just because the sun was out on Sunday. They've been working 12-hour shifts since Monday to clear off snow and ice covered roads and parking lots in the area. Main streets are plowed. Many side streets still need to be cleared. And some people took matters into their own hands and started shoveling and clearing the roads themselves.
When I came out this morning, I was totally blocked in by this heavy snow. As you can see, my mailbox is also blocked in, and I had that clear. And this has obviously just been pushed in front of where my mail delivery is.
Road crews rank priority roads. They say their first focus is always on main streets. And we have a map showing the order in which streets and roads are plowed in Lexington. That's on our website at WKYT.com.
Fayette County Schools back in session this morning after being out all week last week. To make up for that week of school that was canceled, the district has announced a plan. They say they plan to have school on March 20th and April 10th. Both are days where students were originally scheduled to be off. Officials say they'll announce other makeup plans once they're past the chance of having more winter weather. Well, despite the slick road conditions this morning, the University of Kentucky will be on a regular schedule today as well. Classes will be in session, UK offices will be open, and UK healthcare clinics and hospitals will be operating on a normal schedule. UK has been out almost every day last week because of the snowstorms.
In Lincoln County, schools will remain closed today because of snow damage. The Lincoln County superintendent tells us that parking lots and driveways are a mess there. He says a water pipe broke at Lincoln County Middle School and a sprinkler froze up. An awning at Waynesburg Elementary School came down as well. Crews believe that heavy snowfall caused it to cave in. In Frankfort, a group of volunteers is making it their mission to get students back in school this week before they miss too many days. The wintry weather forced many schools in the area to cancel classes. WKYT's Sam Smith has that story from Franklin County.
Classes were canceled at Frankfort Independent Schools all of last week. In order to get back to school this week, the snow on the sidewalks, steps, and parking lots had to go.
Yeah, there were no pathways around the building at all. They were completely covered up and ice underneath them.
Irene Vaughn, her grandchildren, as well as dozens of other volunteers responded to a call to action. Superintendent Rich Crow called for Operation Save Spring Break because their snow days will have to be made up then.
People were bringing their weapons of mass excavation, their shovels and stuff, and snow plows.
Spring break here is usually 3 weeks. Now it's down to 2 weeks. No one here wants to see it get any shorter.
That's what she said this morning. And she said, oh, I don't want to lose my spring break.
Volunteers scraped and salted at Second Street Elementary, Frankfort High, and the Early Learning Academy. Crow is confident school will resume.
We've got places to park for folks tomorrow. We got safe pathways for kids to walk on and steps to get up, and buildings will hopefully be warm, and we'll get school started again tomorrow in Frankfort Independent.
In Frankfort, Sam Smith, WKYT.
And school leaders also had to deal with frozen drains inside the elementary school. Water flowed down through the ceiling and into the hallways there.
Don't forget, you can always track severe weather when you're away from your TV. On WKYT.com, you can take control of an interactive First Alert Defender, and you can zoom into your neighborhood. You can also download the WKYT First Alert Defender radar app for your iPad or your smartphone. Just search for WKYT in your app store. And be sure to help us track the snowfall totals across Kentucky this winter. Send us your photos and videos using the hashtag WKYT Rules Winter.